My dear children, we can just revise what we have learned in the last class. For that, we want to open GIMP software. Click on the applications, then graphics, and click the GNU image manipulation program, that is the GIMP program. Okay, so now the GIMP software is opened. For drawing the image, we want to add a canvas into this software. So how can we add canvas? Click on file, then click on new. Here a window is opened. From here you can add the template as A4. Okay, or else you can increase or decrease the size by adjusting the width and height of the canvas. Okay, then click on the OK button. Now the canvas is displayed here. Now we want to add the toolbox. From the windows you can click on the new toolbox. So now the toolbox is also opened. Just adjust its size. After that you want to open another window, that is layer palette. Okay, so that is also opening from Windows menu. Click on Windows menu, then click on dockable dialogs and go for layers option. Okay, here is the layers. So click on the layers option. Adjust it here. I think layers window is new for you. Why we are opening layers window? In the GIMP software, we are doing all the works in a layer. Okay, so if we are drawing a background, that should be considered as a layer. Then if we are adding that blue logo into the canvas, that should be considered as another layer. Okay, so and the next activity can be considered as another layer. So if we are doing all these activity in a single layer, means we cannot edit it at the last moment. If we want to remove the background, means we cannot remove that if we are doing all the things in a single background. So if we are doing all that things in the part by part or layer by layer, just we want to edit that layer only. Okay, did you understood? Okay, so we have opened the layers window. Now we want to draw the background. So here the background is already created. So now we go for blend tool, then just select the colors for the background. Which colors are the foreground colors and background colors tool? Did you remember all these things? Okay, so click on OK button, and by using the blend tool you can draw the image. Okay, now you want to draw the logo or insert the logo. Just open it from the file, then open recent. We had opened it recently, so it is there. Now you have to click on this select by color tool. Did you remember all these things? Okay, select by color tool and click on the white portion. So white color we want to select, and we are clicking on the white portion. Then click on edit and then click on copy. Okay, after that minimize it. Here you want to create a new layer for that. So did you see, this is the layer palette, and here you can see a plus symbol, that is the create a new layer. So click it. Now a new layer window is open. Here you can give the name for that. So remove the name layer, and you can give the name as logo for later identification. Okay, so I have given the name logo, then click on OK button. So you can see a new layer named logo is displayed here. Just click on that and you can go for edit option. Now you can paste that logo. Paste it. Now the logo is pasted in the canvas. Now we want to scale it, isn't it? So click on the scale tool, then just adjust the size. For what we are using the scale tool? For increase or decrease the size of our image, isn't it? Okay, increase it, then click on the scale button. After that, what is the step? You want to move it. So click on the move tool, then you can move it. So you can see a black color, that is the floating color. Okay, floating layer. So if we want to avoid that, you want to click on the anchor the floating layer in the layers window. So click on the anchor the floating layer, just click it. Now the black color is gone. Okay, now we created two layers. First one is background layer and second one is logo. Can you see an eye button in the left side of each layer? Eyes. Okay, for what we are using that eyes button? If we are clicking on that eyes button, just I am clicking on the eyes button near to the background, what happened? The background has removed. If we are clicking on that again, the background is came. Okay, then if we don't want that logo here, we want to just close that eyes like this. Okay, if we want this, just click on that. Is it clear? Okay, and you know the function of the undo option. For what we are using undo? If you wish to skip the last action and go back to an earlier action, click on the undo option. From where did you get the undo option? Click on the edit menu like this, edit menu, and you can see the undo. Okay, so here undo anchor floating selection, which means in the last portion we have just anchor, isn't it? So undo anchor floating selection means this, we are clicking here, the last action is carried here. Okay, then if we want to redo that, just click on the edit menu and click on the redo option. Okay, so it will restore our work. Is it clear? Okay, so there is a shortcut key for undo and redo. What is that? Undo, control plus Z, and redo, control plus Y, or control plus shift plus Z. Okay, just remember that. Here there is an option for getting the duplicate copy of the layer. So if you want the duplicate of this logo, just click on that, and here you can see the duplicate button. So if you are clicking that duplicate button, another layer is also created like this. Okay, so now we don't want this another copy, and just introduce that duplicate button. So we have to undo this, just click on the control plus Z. Okay, this is the poster you want to create in this chapter. Okay, you can also add the new layer from this layer menu also. Click on the layer, here you can see the new layer. Okay, so just click on that. We are going to add a new layer, remove the name logo, and we can give the name as football. Okay, now we are going to add a picture that children are playing football, so we can give the name to the layer football, then click on the OK. See here, a layer is created named football. Now you go to the home, then go to the school resources, go for standard 9. Here you can see the images folder, click on that, and here you can see the image. Okay, so just open it by right clicking it, then open with other applications, select GIMP, then click on the select button. Now the image is opened with the GIMP. Okay, now we want the black colored portion. Okay, don't want the white portion, we just want black colored portion. So how can we select the black color only? Yes, very good. By clicking on the select by color tool. So just click on the select by color tool and click on the black color. Okay, now we want the football also. So click on the football by clicking on the shift menu. So both the black colors are selected. Okay, now click on the edit option, then just copy it. Now minimize this window and we go for our poster that we have prepared first. Here, so click on the football. Now go for edit option and click on the paste button. Okay, now that image is pasted. Now you want to move it or resize it. Move it by using move tool like this. Then resizing means using the scale tool. Okay, you can adjust the size. Like this. Okay, click on the scale button. Now here you can see that floating layer, so click on the anchor tool in the layer palette. Click on the anchor tool. Okay, if you want to rename this, there is two option. If you want to rename the background name, just right click it, then go for edit layer attributes. Just click on that and here you can see the existing name as background. Just remove that and you can give the BG color, BG. Okay, so short form for background. Then click on OK. Now the name background is changed into BG. Okay, if you want to rename it, just double click on that and remove that and you can give the name. Okay, like this. Now we are moving to activity 1.5, that is placing logo in the poster. So we want to add a logo that say no to child labor. We want to type that message in our poster. So let us see how can we add the logo into our poster. For creating the logo, click on the file menu. Then just click on the create. And here you can see the logos. Okay, logos option. From this, you can select any one option. Then here you can see the pattern. You can just browse it. So just click on the other option and then close it. You can add here, say no to child labor. Okay. Now click on the OK button. You can see the logo. Just copy it and paste it on the logo. Click on the edit option. Here just copying it and you can minimize it. Here you want to create a new layer by clicking on the create a new layer button and giving the name as text or text logo. Okay, click on OK button. Then you can paste it. See what is happening there. See, if we are increasing the size like this, and removing the anchor, you can see only that violet colored letters. So if we want this white background also, you want to click on the edit button, then You can see the layer palette of this logo's window. This is the layer palette of this logo. So here you can see one option is not active. So just click on that. Here you can see the black color also. Okay, so if we want to copy these three portions, you want to copy it, edit, then click on the copy visible option. Okay, so if you don't want this portion, just remove that. If you don't want this portion, you can just remove that. Okay, so if you want, click on that and you can click copy visible option. Like this. Then go for our poster and just undo your work and select the layer and you can give paste option. See, now the black background also came. Now you can resize it by using the scale tool and move it. Clicking on the anchor tool. Okay. You can just adjust the positions here. Like this. Okay. Now click on the background. Here you can see the selection is like this. So just click on the background in your layer. Now that selection is go for background. Okay. So dear children, you are to remember the use of this eye icon. Okay. So if you are clicking on this eye icon, just I am clicking on the layer text logo. Okay, so I am hiding this layer. Now the layer is not visible here. If we want to show it, just click on this eye icon. Okay, now it is appeared here. So the eye icon is used to view and hide a layer. Okay. Now if you want to delete a layer, just click on that layer and you can click here. This is the delete layer. Okay, if you don't want that layer, you can click here. Okay, now we are going to save it. File, save as. You can go to home. Then you want to create a new folder named students work 9th. So create folder. Here you can give as students work 9th. Now a new folder is created and here you can give the new name. Okay, so now here you can see untitled as the name. Just double click on that and remove here. And you can give the name. Okay. Activity 1. Did you listen that? Here you can see a .xcf. What is that? What is PNG? And what is JPG? Yes, it is all are the file formats. JPG and PNG are the file formats for the images. Okay. Then what is the file format for the GIMP software? That is .xcf. Okay. So keep that in your mind. .xcf is the file format for GIMP software. After giving the name, then click on the save button here. Now your work is saved with the name activity1.xcf in the GIMP software. Okay, so dear children, now we are going to wind up today's class and we can go for next class by the next topics. So Till then, you want to write your notebook and you want to make one word question and answer. Okay, so write it in your fair notebook. So, my dear children, we can meet at the next class. Till then, you want to take care, stay home, stay safe. Okay, thank you.